Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Ali's Stitching Studio Flosstube. It's been a little while, hasn't it? It has been, I don't know, like a year since I filmed, and before that, it was a 3-year break. So, quite regular Flosstuber, as you can see. So, I will just do a very quick life update for you in the first few minutes, and then we'll get straight into the action, because I'll just let you see I have got a world of sharing, and if we go this way, you can see onto the ground of stuff. So, lots to share, lots to talk about, and see that? That's my husband's hobby. I'm a golf widow at times. He's now kind of semi-retired and hitting the golf course 2 or 3 times a week. And that's his, which way are we going? That's his thing. He covers a woody. I don't know what that is. It's a big stick. With a gorilla head, he won in a competition. So, now we're talking about golf. So, you'll get the gist of how I roll. It's a little bit of everything. Cross stitch and quilting are my main two things. If you haven't met me before, hello, welcome. My name's Alison, but no one calls me that. My mother, maybe, when I'm in trouble. It's Ali. Ali likes to cross stitch and quilt predominantly. I dabble in scrapbooking. I dabble in card making and mosaicing. Came back on the scene last year. Got a little bit of that to show. Where did I put that here? This is something that sits in my craft room, and this was a tissue box that I started, I don't know, 20 years ago, and I just finished it last year when I came back and I finished grouting. So there we go. That's a tissue box that sits up on the shelf over there. So what have I been doing? I have been away. I used to film regularly before I went to America to the first Flosstube New Jersey retreat. Back in 2018, I filmed regularly prior to that, and then I just stopped before I went. I just felt that it wasn't something that I wanted to focus on, and I have really been focusing on my family. I've got 2 teenage daughters who are now 17 and 18. We've gone through the driving. We're still going through it with the youngest, getting 100 hours so they can get their license and be up and off. I've had changing work situations. I no longer work for our business, and I've gone out into the workforce and had numerous jobs, some of them extremely physical, where I have not felt like coming home and talking about anything I'm doing. I've still stitched a lot and still craft as a release, but I haven't felt like discussing it. I've just been physically very tired. And picked up another job a year or so ago. 18 months ago, which I absolutely love, and I'm bus driving for special needs kids. So I do the morning pickup and the afternoon drop off to their homes, to the school and back, and I absolutely love it. I love it, and I'll be there until the day I stop working. I love my families and the kids that I work with every day. It is just the joy of a job. So it's something that I just adore driving this bus. I adore the kids and seeing the families every day and being part of their lives. And I won't do anything else. I was doing little things on the side as well, but this will be enough for me now. Because I'm focusing on the physical stuff I'm doing is with my sport, which is softball. Those of you who have followed me for a long time know that I'm just a softball fanatic. I play all year round, summer and winter seasons. We're about to start winter again now here. On Sunday. Currently I'm filming this on Thursday. If only I was holding a device in my hand that would tell me that. Thursday the 8th of April. So I'll upload this video straight away. So hopefully you won't get it too late after that date I've just given you. So we'll start our winter season on the 11th, Sunday the 11th. Again, I've had about 6 weeks off from summer season finishing. So I focus on playing all year round, which is a game once a week and training once a week. And then outside of that, I also go to the gym, and I do 4, 5, 6 sessions a week at my little boutique gym, which I absolutely love. I've done challenges with them. I've got my little crew of people that I love to train with, and I've gotten really healthy. I've lost about 20 kilos. I don't know what that is in pounds for you who are watching overseas. I have no idea, but I'm just the fittest I've been in a long time since I was running when the kids were babies, and I'm loving life and focusing on making sure I have a balance with work, domestic, staying fit, my crafts, still getting lots done. If you followed me on Instagram, you can see that I'm still very, very active in my craft, but I'm making sure I have physical movement as a big part of my day, and also just eating really cleanly and eating well. So that's my, in a nutshell. Obviously I could talk for 10 hours about what I've been doing, but that would clearly, at 5 minutes and 53 seconds, I think we've had our Ali life update wrapped up. So here we are. I'm back to share all this goodness. I've been binge watching some people that I've been hearing about that I hadn't watched because I've been just binge watching a lot of Netflix. So I've been enjoying just watching a lot of you and getting inspiration to film again. So clearly I didn't know I was filming when I woke up this morning. I decided to do it half an hour ago. I've pulled my stuff together. So as Ali does, it'll be just me talking. I'm not shy. I'll talk to all of you quite eloquently. I don't have notes, so, but you will probably hear some rustling for things that aren't in homemade project bags. I've got so much to discuss, guys. Okay, so the first thing I wanted to show you was, you can just see a tidbit of some of the things that I finished recently. I don't know what I finished in the last year. There's so much of it. So we'll just randomly, this video will be ad hoc. I'm going to sprinkle it with a whole heap of goodness. Buckle in, grab a drink. Okay, so years ago, I used to go to craft shows and just take my little trolley, take hundreds of dollars and get my gear for the year, right? All of my gear, all my goodness, kits on this, kits on that, whatever was in at the time, I was into it, loved it. I got so much stuff. Anyway, so one of the things I got was a embroidery kit for this shiziki embroidery, which is Japanese embroidery. It's just like just a back stitch or just a straight stitch with your lever gap. And this was a pre-printed panel, and it's just done with a really thick embroidery thread, which I didn't bring over. It's somewhere here, the leftovers. It just, it's very thick. And look, it's fine. I just found it really, I didn't want to pick it up. It's really quite boring. I have got the other side of this panel that's not printed that I'll do something with. It's a nice sort of indigo, deep indigo coloured fabric. So I finished this into a cushion using some Asian themed fabric backing with the zip on it. This insert isn't the right size. It should sit like that. So once I get the right size insert, this is actually a cushion I made for my sister. So I actually didn't end up buying the right size because I'll send this down. She lives in Melbourne. I live in Brisbane. And I'll send this down to her and she can buy her own insert in Melbourne to fit this. So I've sort of just been using this. But next time I send a care package down to her, which will have books and things in it because we do that regularly, I will also send this and I'll have the insert out of it and just it'll be a pillow that she can fill. So at the moment I've just been enjoying it on my sewing chair in here, but it will go and get sent on. So in the background you can see my big red ship of life, and I'm showing this because I know Miss Olivia B will be watching this, and Miss Olivia needs to see this because she needs inspiration, because I know she's towards the end of her big red ship of life, and I know she's going to be thinking right now, I love this piece but I equally hate this piece. So this is a message for you, Olivia. And some inspiration, so you keep going, girl. Now this is, I started this years ago when Death by Cross Stitch came out and I was filming. I said to everyone, I'm not buying that. I've got a chart the same size. I'm going to stitch Big Red Ship Alive. And then Mama Ulu jumped in with me, Pammy from Pam's Craft Corner. Olivia B, a heap of ton of people jumped in, and we just all started stitching this big red ship of life. And I don't know who's finished it, Mama Ulu, because her needles are practically on fire. She's so fast, Davina. Pammy's still going on hers. Olivia B is actively working towards her finish now. So here we go. So it came with an 18 count aider in the kit that I got this in from Fox Collection, and I didn't like the white, so I stained it with like a Rit dye, a tan Rit dye. And that's it finished. Now what I did was I lined it with a interfacing because I wanted like a little bit of thickness. Now all I've done is turned it over and put thing. So this is finished in case I ever want to frame it. Now I know I was listening to quite a few people and they're saying this. I'm thinking, wow, I do that too. Like, because I haven't put it in a frame, I kind of mentally think, is this really a permanent finish I'm doing or not? So yes, when it hangs on the wall, it's as neat as a pin and you don't see any of that. It's just been finished because I did want the finish to be quite close to the end stitching. I really do like, even when things are framed with a choice, I like it to be quite tightly finished. So that I've just sewn around and hand sewn down onto there because this rod doesn't come off. It's a fixed rod. This was, I've got a beautiful Auntie Dawn, who won't be watching this. But I love Auntie Dawn, and she brings me a whole heap of eclectic, wonderful collectibles. She has my whole life, whatever age I was at. Now she knows what my tastes are in my home, and all the cool stuff is from Auntie Dawn. So years ago, she had a friend that travelled, and she had this piece, but she didn't want any more. And she said to me, do you want it? And I went, oh, yes, because at the time I was stitching this, and when I measured it, look at that, that's it to the end of this little. And that's why I had to stitch it on, because this doesn't come off. There's no way for me to like slip this on and off kind of thing. Look at that. So I've got a couple of inches. So it sits with an inch either side kind of thing. Is that not perfect? So the Big Red Ship of Life is from based on Sumatran weavings of the people that were obviously very much had a fishing culture. So we've got some random. And I did a funny giveaway on Instagram because I was stitching something towards the end. What was it? This thing here. What is that? So, oh no, it was this one. I beg your pardon. Look at this. What is that creature? And Zerlina from Canada had the funniest answer, so I sent her a chart as a little just. Giveaway. So anyway, so this is a beautiful piece, Big Red Ship of Life. It's stunning. I love it. And it's a hua. She's a big hua. She hangs, you can go back through my Instagram, Ali's Stitching Studio, and see where it hangs in my house. It hangs on my, walking up to my, sorry, that's a way. I've got a squeaky chair and that's way too close a shot, isn't it, of my head. Okay, so some other finishes we'll go on with. Here is a Lanart kit, Green Ara. I'm pretty sure I wasn't filming Flosstube when I finished this. So I'll show it here now. This was a 50 cent frame from a charity store. I love what we call op shopping in Australia. Secondhand shopping, what do you call them over there? Junking. I've heard Laurie say junking. She goes, junking. So this had just under there is, I think, a picture of Bangkok in the 70s or something. And so I just mounted that onto a thing and stuck it there. And I love this. This hangs in my bedroom. Again, look at Insta if you want photos of that. Here's another Olivia B. reference. Girl! You want to see this? The back stitching on this nearly killed me. Nearly killed me. Mm-hmm. I was ready to wave the white flag. I love Debbie Patrick, and on my old videos, I had a whole video dedicated to her 30-something charts a beautiful friend of mine, Joe, gave me. But damn, the backstitching, losing the will to live. Every one of these little tiles in these roofs has backstitching around it. Now I did, was it there? I think I put a poll up on Insta. I couldn't even see it. The colour they wanted me to do it in, I'm doing it and literally losing my eyesight. And I'm looking at it and I'm thinking, I can't even see it's in there. And I've just spent 6 hours backstitching a tiny little section and I can't see it's there. So I've learned many valuable lessons by stitching this. I absolutely adore this. It's Debbie Patrick. It's Winchester Mystery Mansion. She does a series of Victorian homes across America and they are stunning. I've even got a conservatory, I think, as it's in San Francisco. I've got a mansion from France. Stunning designs. And I love Jay's from Jay's X stitches them regularly. Mama Ulu stitches Debbie Patrick. Miss Olivia stitches Debbie Patrick. I've just sent this chart to Pammy in Newfoundland. They're stunning. They're absolutely stunning. I mean, this is a house. I'm really not into other designers that do simplistic little square boxes of a home. If it's part of a bigger picture or a sampler, I'll do it. But I'm not going to mention their names and run companies down, but I really don't like it. I like realism in my cross-stitch, really, for most of my work. So that's what I'm going for. And one more chunky finish that I'll show you is this gorgeous big boy. That is the, I want to say it's called Belted Kingfisher by Frostwing Collection. This is a really nasty cheap frame. It's plastic. It's really lightweight. But I tell you what, it's up on the wall above a hand-painted cabinet I did last year. And it looks amazing. Look at the beautiful little French knot. Aren't they stunning? It's just a really nice complementary piece to this design. The colorways in this is all DMC. It's on the proper Frostwing collection, did their own fabric for certain charts. Now, I don't know if that's something that they still do. I don't know if that's a common practice or whether in this time and day and age with all the problems that there are having worldwide supply of fabrics, whether they still do fabric. I have zero idea about that, but this was the proper fabric for this chart, and I absolutely, if I buy another chart of theirs, I will attempt to buy their fabric if I can, because it was beautiful to work on. Can't tell you what it was. It's there, maybe 32, I don't know. Okay, so for years and years and years, I have thought about, because my history is quilting and cross stitch. I picked up in cross stitch in 94 and quilting in 95. That's when I started. So around the same time, same length of time roughly in my life, I have done these things. So we're heading up to 25, 26, 27 years of doing these things now. So I've always done variations of both or both at the same time or combine them or done little gifts for friends. I've always felt like that's a great thing to be able to have both, but obviously a baby quilt for a little one is very quick to make compared to stitching. Even if you stitch a small cross stitch design, it's going to be 20, 30, 40 hours. I can knock up a quilt a lot quicker than that. So I've done variations of the both and hum and haw between what I'm into. So I knew I had the skills to make project bags, but I just never put any. And I didn't want to just bang out a project bag with fabric on the inside, fabric on the outside, and that's it. I wanted to do something that would combine what my skill set is. But it wasn't in the too hard basket. It was in the basket of I really don't even want to think about it at the moment, so I'm focusing on other things. So I've had, obviously, as I said, I've been culling a lot of stuff out of my life with different work and just the things I really want to do. Things I really want to do. One of them is talking to you guys because I've missed you all. And obviously staying in contact through Instagram with a lot of you and different ones I stitch with. But it's been really beautiful to think, you know, I've got a clean slate now and I'm going to get back on Flosstube and have a chat with everyone. But this is how we go. Ali just goes off on tangents. I'm going to show you some of the bags I've made and what's in them. So I think there's some Stitch Asia things in there. I'll just start off by saying two years ago, Lisa from Kindred Stitches sent me a care package because she's a beautiful girl. We'd been talking and then we finally met at Flosstube in New Jersey and we just hit it off. I sat between her and Laurie and we just had the best time at that retreat. I laughed and laughed so hard. We were having lunches and dinners together. We were the gang of three. It was great. We just loved it. Anyway, Lisa sent me a care package a couple of years ago and she sent me one of her bags, which is beautiful with a little, this is a good idea, little buttons on it. So it's Halloween themed. I don't stitch Halloween, so I don't have a Halloween project in here. What I have in here is, it's a beautifully made bag too, ink circles, this one. You're not even going to convince me to attempt to say that. Now, years ago, Carissa from Carissa's Life had a sale and she sold Eva Stash. And she's a very talented person. If you're not following her, she doesn't film. She won't film. I've asked her a few times. She is on Instagram. Carissa's Life does beautiful work. Very talented quilter as well. And she was selling a heap of cross-stitch stuff. And she sold quilting like a stash sale. So all the way from Canada, I ordered two big chunks of stuff. I was so excited. It must be 3 years ago going on now. So one of the things I picked up from her was this chart with the cord for. This was what's so exciting to me because I would never kit up a project. 12 skeins of Carrie's Creation Infinity. It's lovely. It's a silk floss that's hand dyed and it's quite variegated. I'm really loving it. And I had some white fabric that I picked up in Needleworkers Delight in New Jersey. And I had a good start on this a few months ago. So if you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen this, but showing it live for those who don't have Instagram or like to see things live. So here we are. Now this is on a it's a 28. I would have guessed 32. It's a 28 antique white Lagana. And look at that. There is still more to go down here. That's not the bottom of the chart, so that's the top. It's just a beautiful piece. I'm going to really enjoy it. I don't know where I'm going to hang this in my house. I'll have to have a think about it. But this is a beautiful, I love ink circles. I've got obviously Big Red Ship's Life is ink circles. I've got a number of their things. Ali's Stash is off the hook. I'm going to start to show some of it today just to make myself accountable. I'm looking at the time now. It's 23 minutes. Girls, I haven't even started. And boys, girls and boys, I haven't even started. Okay, here we go. So this is the start of Ali's project bags. Oh, let me go in chronological order of birth. So the birth of my first project bag was this little itty bitty one. I had this. This was a log cabin quilt I made for my nephew when he was a baby. Now he's just turned 19. So I had an extra block because I was just banging out blocks. And then by the time I did the size, I'm like, I'm stopping now and I've run out of whatever thing. Anyway, so I had this spare block forever. And it was a bit ratty around the corner. So this is the size I had to make it. But I followed Celeste Creates' tutorial on bag making. Thank you, honey. Wonderful, wonderful. Because I think things that were stopping me mentally from making project bags, guys, was I wanted something where, like, I like the ones where the zip goes there, but I wanted the full front. When, you know, anyone who has scrapbooked or paper cards and stuff. You know, you're working with the page or you're working with a card front. So it's that full bit of canvas that you're working on that's exciting. So I didn't want like a canvas with a big zip 3/4 of the way up. Like that was the mental block, I think, in my head. As a creator, I didn't want that zip halfway through my creation. So when I saw Celeste's tutorial on making a zip at the top, I went, bang, that's the little piece of the mental puzzle I've been waiting for. I will do them with a top-loaded zipper, and then I've got the whole canvas on the top. And I also knew I wanted to have a heavily quilted, so there's padding, there's wadding either side of these, there, and they're heavily quilted. Because I absolutely love quilting. I absolutely love when I finish a quilt, I hand quilt all my own quilts. I don't send them away, I quilt them myself. And I love that stage of the project. Like I'm churning through projects. When I get to a certain stage, I can't wait to get to the quilting on my quilting machine. So making these bags, I get to quilt and quilt away. You know, then my eyeballs bleed. So here we are. I've just done this, and this is obviously, as I said to you, a quilt block from a very long time ago. But I didn't. I should have added something around it. It's just quite small. I'll show you compared to the size I ended up making. But this was just like a test piece. I wanted to test it with this block to see if, in my head, a quilt block on the front, or I had what I thought I could do. And look, no problems, following Celeste's tutorial, easy, it was fun. Now what I have in here is a little start that I haven't started yet. This was another chart I got from Carissa's Life on her sale. And it's one I just see everyone's referring to. There must be a lot of people stitching it at the moment. Cross Stitch Nation by Heartstring Samplery. And I want to start this. Now, I really, God love the designer, but I don't like those colours. I'm going to do it on just a white linen. What's that? 32. And I'm going to use some of my favourite colourways for cross stitch. It's not how I decorate in my house, but I really like visually seeing them together. And there are a lot of blues and greens. So all of those dresses, I am going to change and add some of these. Now, I've got a lot of other ones to play with, but each of those dresses in that chart will be one of these colours. There's a man in there too, so I'll play around with his jacket. So there we go. So that's one project that I will start soon. Not just yet, but that is definitely, as we say, on the radar. I love that saying. I love it. Okay, so story time in Ali's studio. When I started making these, and I put on Instagram, I love making these bags, would anyone like to buy them? I was really thinking about selling them. A few problems with that. I've sent one to Pammy, and I've sent one to Lena Finch, my girl. Hey, Lena, I know you're going to be watching this. Hey, honey, I hope you're well. She had sent me a beautiful package of stuff I picked up when I was in Newfoundland at Pammy's, and I wanted to send her back. I'll take a photo and insert it here if I can. I'll just put this thing here. Insert it here to show the bag that I sent her in Newfoundland, and I sent another bag to Pammy, which she shared on her Instagram. And it took a long time for those packages to get there, like over a month. So my concern is, talking to you, obviously I've got a lot of viewers in the Northern Hemisphere, and I'm in Brisbane, Australia, Queensland, Australia. If I sell you something, I mean, these are well-made bags, they're big, they take about 3 to 4 hours to make of my time, and there's more involved ones here. And postage is going to be about 25 Australian. We're talking a chunk of money for a bag. Like it's going to be about $100 a bag. And I can't see that and taking about I don't know, a month, 6 weeks to get there. That concerns me. So I have, I'm going to show you some of my stash today. I have so much stash, I can make project bags till the cows come home for myself and not be stressing. I don't want stress in my life on any level, on any level. I just don't. So that would be very stressful to me. If I sell you a bag, I know I've done the right thing. I would, this was my thought process, I would make a chunk of bags in a collection. That's why all these bags have similar colorways, because I even labeled them people. Raspberry Denim was going to be the name of this collection I'm going to show you now, which I've absorbed into my own to use for myself. But I would understand if I brought something from someone in Australia and I lived in America and I've paid for it and I've paid good money and I've paid for postage and waiting, it's just not coming. And it's nothing to do with me. And what if that thing gets lost? I'd be feeling so bad on your behalf, but it's something that is outside my control, the postage issue. I can't control that. I used to, when Pammy would send me stuff, I'd send stuff to her or I'd order from America. 2 weeks. I knew 2 weeks. No drama. It would come in 2 weeks, right? I can't guarantee that now. And I would just be stressing about that. And as I said, I don't want stress in my life. So that's why, thank you. If you give me the compliment and say I should sell these, I will definitely absorb that compliment and say thank you very much. But at this point in time, with the unpredictability of postage worldwide, not going to do it. I'm not going to do it to myself and I'm not going to do it to you as a customer. If I decide to sell these within Australia, that might be a different thing. If there's Australian viewers, I might. But again, it would put me under time stress to make them and get them ready. If I do, it'll be, here's a collection of 20 and I'll put them on the Instagram page. Bang. Have at it. It won't be. I won't take custom orders and stuff. Life's too short. Anyway. All that to say, here's the bags that I had a world of fun matching up what I was doing. So this was a panel I got when I was in Missouri Star Quilt Co. on my big Ali's Great Big Adventure to the US and Canada, where she went after the Flosstube retreat to Missouri Star Quilt Co. And actually, they probably put a statue up in my name in the main street because I did donate a hunk of Australian dollars to that town. It's well documented. They're still talking about it. So anyway, if you go to Missouri Star Quilt Co., look for the statue. Might look a little bit about me, like me, maybe a little bit chubbier. Anyway, so here is one of the panels I brought. I think there were six of these on a quilted panel. And it says Farm Life. And I've just cut these things out of some fabric I had here. I've put some cute little gingham, made some little bows. See, this was what was fun for making project bags for me, was doing the creative elements on the front and deciding, and even like down to, this is another thing. I have got scrapbook paper. Can you see it? Is it in where? Am I blocking it? No, it's in the other direction over there. Next time we set up, I'll show you my scrapbook paper. I have got a whole tower of it, thousands and thousands of pieces of scrapbook paper. I wouldn't have problems coordinating paper with my fabric because I've got thousands of pieces of fabric. The struggle's real, people. Anyway, home spun type fabric on the back, coordinated. And that was going to be how my bags are, a bit mixed media, a bit coordinated, but not matchy-matchy. And there you go, the insides are matching there. Quite often I use a fat quarter on one side and another fat quarter on the other. Anyway, what is in this one? Ooh, people, I love this one. Paws and claws. This was a chart that I got from Gift of Stitching and I loved it, but I did not like the peachy tones, the back stitching. I don't mind backstitching, but this would kill a buzzard. Look at it. Every single tiny little thing is backstitched. And plus, I also feel it kind of dates the chart. And I sort of saw through that and saw that I love that. I love the sentiment. It says, none but cats and dogs may quarrel in my house. Wonderful. Live and let live. I live with two dogs and a cat. I love that. So what I did was I started it when I got back from Newfoundland, because while I was there, we went to a quilt store, Pammy and I. It was just a little quilt store. It was cute. It was upstairs in the old town section of where she lives. And they had Valdani cotton threads. Now, I hadn't seen Valdani cotton threads before. I brought black and khaki, chimney dust, and seaside. They're hand-dyed, variegated, but subtle hand dyes. They're really quite classy looking. And I just picked three. I think I've got another one somewhere. I just picked three that I like the look of with zero project in mind, right? And then I came home and started this, and I'm stitching it thinking, this is on vintage country mocha. Is it? Let's just say that, for argument's sake. And I decided that all that backstitching that dated the chart, once I took it out, look how magnificent. I mean, I know this is my work. I shouldn't call it magnificent, but it's Long Dog, isn't it? It's Long Dog's magnificent chart. Look at it. I hope to see a spike in sales on this chart, people. I'm telling you, because it is bloody fantastic. Look. Look at the magnificence of that. Now you can see I've stopped 3/4 of the way because I got burnt out. I really did do a chunk on this in one go. I loved it. And the only backstitching I've kept are the tendrils around the border, because that would look weird. You'd have floating leaves and floating berries. That would just look weird. So that's the only backstitching I've kept in this whole chart, I think. I've put the Valdani threads here. I've come up. All the cats and the dogs and the birds are in black. So that's a design element I really like. I think that's classy in this. I've changed the urns. The house is completely changed. The house on the chart was apricot. Nope, sorry. I've done the Valdani threads throughout the whole house. I've kept the black windows. Oh, I beg your pardon. And there's backstitching in the house there to pick out the windows. How amazing is this chart now, people? And look at, they're called four colours. Look at this. Even though I got this in the back of Gift of Stitching, I know this is available to buy still. Look at that. That looks aqua. This is more periwinkle. And look at that house compared to this house. Guys, synergy worked well. I love this. I'm finishing this soon. I think about this one all the time. I can't wait to get this framed and up on my wall. I'll pay a framer to do that one. I've been, all those things I showed you here, actually my finishes, ones... I didn't bring you my pirate. Next video. I did a mirror last year, and it was Lady Pirate, and I paid for that to get framed, and it's stunning, and I did some adaptions on that piece as well, but I'll save that. That'll give me something to show you next time. Not that I'm going to run out of things to show you. Boy! Not running out anytime soon. Here's another one. With that same thing, with the different coloured, I used denim. I cut up an old pair of jeans of mine. Some homespun. What have I got inside? Oh, they're matching again. Must have had more than a fat quarter of that fabric. And here is my beloved, one of my beloved, Debbie Patrick's Angel of the Sea. I started this because Heather from Springfield Stitcher. Hey girl, how you going? She's amazing. I love her. I've been watching her for years. She's very clever. She's studying to become a court reporter. I don't know. Girl, you must have fingers on fire. Typing so quickly to do that. That's amazing. So we met in New Jersey in person, and she took me to her gym, and we did a gym class one Saturday morning during the retreat. And I came back all hot and sweaty and had to have a... shower before I went down into the room and started stitching. So that was good because I'd been sitting around a lot on planes and traveling and stuff, and I really loved getting into the gym and hitting it hard. So, hey girl, it was really nice to meet you and hang out with you at the gym. So thank you. Anyway, why did I go there with that? She showed, was it last year? Year before maybe. She'd been, I think, into an area near here for a trip. She puts all these cool videos on her, photos on her Instagram about places that she's traveled, and she likes all the spooky abandoned houses and stuff. And I don't know if she showed this house or reminded me of this when I saw it and went, oh, girl, I'm having a birthday start. So I did have a birthday start on this. This is an even weave from somewhere, from someone. And it was just a dove kind of a grey. Look at that. I love Debbie Patrick Charts. The beauty of her work is just... Yeah, that's a house. They're the house charts I like. They can be infuriating. You can be like, ah! Because you keep changing. But look at the detail you get. Like, the detail's brilliant. You can't fault the detail. Now, lesson learnt. You may call me a fool, but lesson learnt, people. Look, Ali is backstitching before this chart ends. I've started backstitching. See? So I am going to be backstitching, as Miss Olivia B says, put a few strands of backstitching before you start stitching. And girl, absolutely, I'm not Winchester Mystery Mansion taught me a lot in life, and it taught me that. Sorry, I have to pause for a minute. My